Oh, toes out, so the hoes out. What's poppin'?
What's poppin'? What's poppin'? You guys, your boy Mr. THC, man. We're back at it with the bangers. We about to do a little dispo run right now. You know what I'm saying? I'm here in my city, and I'm gonna go to one of the local shops out here, and we're gonna go see what they have. We're gonna go scoop the scene around, and I'm gonna see if I can bring you guys inside with me. So usually you guys know how it goes, man. Most dispos, you can't even pull out your phone. They'll trip on you. But thankfully, man, thanks to you guys supporting, liking, subscribing, your boy THC can sometimes pull a string here or there. You know what I'm saying? And if you're watching this video, man, make sure you comment down below and let me know what city and state you're watching from, man. Let's get it. So we just pulled up to VRC, Vallejo Relief Center. You know what I'm saying? This is what it looked like. This is the local shop here for me. Just gonna park up. They just added these parkings too, which is so much, like, it's so clutch. Let's see what they got. Let's see what they got. Good.
It's all good.
See? We live, man. Look at this artwork, though. Got you guys an inside edition film, huh? Inside the dispo and shit. What's good, Bri? What's up with you? How you living? All right, bro. I'm looking for some fire flower.
From Mount Vernon right away. I do got this bubblegum silky, that pineapple silky. These are from Goonies and Backpack Boys. This Bombay and this Mushu right here.
Yo, this is fire. I remember trying this like hella long ago. This is bomb. Have you tried it?
I know. I heard it smells and tastes just like bubblegum.
It's fire. How much are these?
These are going for 60 if I'm not mistaken.
60, 120. All right, I'll take, what is this?
This is Bombay from Backpack Boys. I'm not mistaken, this one's 70. And this one, oh shit. Let me see. Some other options for you.
What's this?
This blue slushy from Backpack Boys as well, the Duzaline and the Skyhook 33.
These are all Backpack Boys, huh?
Correct.
Hey yo, big shout out Backpack Boys. If you guys didn't see my last video, we dropped the strain there, so go tap in with Backpack Boys, you know what I'm saying? But nah, look, I'm gonna do these, bro. I'm gonna do two.
Two?
Those are the ones I want.
And actually, these are going on the 70, man, and I do have your total on 280.
Sheesh. Oh, got you, bro. And just like that, yo, we in and we out, man. We're gonna go try out these flavors and see what it do. All right, you guys, so we're about to go pick up the compa Francisco right now. We got all the goodies. I have a surprise for Francisco. And also, I want to hook up some random person today, man, because I'm feeling really giving today. You know what I'm saying? So we're going to pump some gas, pick up the homie Francisco, surprise him, surprise some random stranger on the street. Man, let's get it. You still like when your boy Mr. THC. Come on. Guys, we're pumping at almost $7 a tank. Welcome to California, baby. $7 a tank, god damn. Oh boy, $75 for less than 11 gallons of that. Damn! America! I feel so American paying these prices.
Hello,
what's up, man?
Touching
this man's hand.
I
got a surprise for you.
Well, what's up?
Close your eyes. Put your hands up.
Nah.
Nothing weird, nothing weird, nothing weird. I always see you puffing on that little vape shit. And I had to just get you right one time, bro.
Thank you. You know what? Tell them
like,
first.
Show them, bro.
Hold on.
Show them this little thing, bro. Show them the upgrade
I
just gave
you.
I hope you lost it. God damn it. I hope it's lost somewhere between. Yeah. Just show them one time, bro. What you were puffing on, bro. He always be like, do you want to take a hit out of this? And I'm like, no, bro. Come show them, bro. Show them the hot dog water you had. Show them what you had before, bro.
Here, hold on. All right, look. So, it's the Boof juice, the hot dog water. Look at that. But I get this from the club for like $35.
No, we don't need that no more.
We don't need it no more.
Dude, you're upgraded, my boy.
Thanks, bro.
Hello, bro. You already know, bro. Hello, you already know, bro. We gotta hook the homies up one time, bro. All the time, man. Let's go.
Bro, plug and play is so fire, bro.
Hell yeah.
Thank you, bro. This is so fucking fire, bro. I always want to try plug and play.
All right, like I said, you guys, we're going to hook up a random stranger. You know what I'm saying? I blessed my boy up, but right now I wanted to hook up a random stranger. This person I'm going to hook up, I actually just blessed him like a couple days ago with like some bread and like some products and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? And I actually ran into him while I was pumping gas, and he was like, dude, I would cry for like 3 hours because I lost what you gave me. And I was like, don't worry about it, bro. Give me 10 minutes. I said, give me 10 minutes. We'll go pick my homie up. I'll be right back, bro. Don't worry about it, bro. I don't want to hear like you cried, bro. I want you to have a good day. You know what I'm saying? Look, look, look. He's already walking up to the car. He already knows it's about to go down, bro. Watch this, watch this, watch this. What's up, bro? Gotta bless you up one time. Come here, come here. The light's turning. Come here, come here, come here. Got that little QP for the homie right here. Yo. Throw it in your backpack, bro. Show the camera. Show the what you got.
Egg.
Little QP. Throw it in your camera. Enjoy that. Yo.
Enjoy. Enjoy.
Just bust that phone with the QP one time. You know what I'm saying?
What the fuck was that?
I wait out for
him. Yeah, I thought you were going to have him like a fucking plug and play, bro.
Nah, dude. We threw him a QP, bro. Just bless that fool one time. I felt good, man.
That felt great.
Come on,
what the
man.
Fuck? That's what I'm talking about, bro.
He said,
give him back. He was choking up, bro. Oh my
Come
God.
Come on.
He was not expecting that, bro.
Why are you pulling up on me, gang? We chilling. ¿Qué pasó, güey? This fool hella pulling up on us. Like, why are you just watching my video, bro? Chill.
If you guys want to see me do more giveaways like the one I did earlier to the dude that was outside, make sure you guys destroy the like button on this video. But right now, we're going to get on with the video, man. We are going to smoke like a boss. So I want to give a big special shout out to my people, Purple Rose Supply, man. This is a build your own cannon guard. Now, this cannon guard is really special because this is a 14 grammer, you guys. This fits 14 grams. So I went to the dispo, you know what I mean? I picked up some of my local gas. These were about almost like $60 an eighth or so. So I think after taxes and everything was like $280. But I'm gonna walk you guys through how we're gonna set this up. Hence why I brought the homie with me, because he's also gonna burn it down with me as well. And yeah, so we're just gonna go ahead, we're gonna pop this bad boy straight out the box, you know what I'm saying? This is a device that you use to make your cannon guard, okay? You have like a filter essentially that you can use, like where you would put your mouth. This is your mouthpiece. And then these right here, which they look something like kind of like a long toothpick essentially, is what we're going to put inside our device right here so that we can pack our product into it. So what you want to do is you want to go ahead and you want to open this bad boy up. So the first thing you're going to want to peep, you guys, if you see right here, this is like your packing device, right? There's a hole right there, right inside. And that's where you're gonna want this piece to go into when you pack down your product. So you get the pointy end, you put the pointy end straight through, and there's also a hole here at the bottom of this one. So you wanna put the product like this, flat on the table, okay? So you wanna put the pointy side in first, and then with the hole that you have up here, you would put this stick part in here, okay? So like that way you can pack it down. So you would put the stick in and then you could pack your product down. So all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grind down my 14 grams now, you know what I'm saying? And we're gonna go ahead and stuff it in here. Now this size specifically, you guys, is set for a 14 grammer. They do offer different sizes as well. So they have like a 2 to 4 grammer, which I think is more casual for like the day-to-day person. They also have like a 3.5, which is like an eighth, like a quarter, I believe so. And if you guys ever wanna do one and you don't wanna do such a big one, you know, but if you ever wanna live like a Mr. THC moment, you wanna surprise your homies, you're going to a party, you're doing something special, man, and it's somebody's birthday, I don't know, you bust this bad boy out, you put in 14 grams, man, you don't give a flying fuck, and you make it happen, you know what I'm saying? So I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna grind down the fire, you guys, and then we're gonna pack this bad boy down, man, let's get it. I actually haven't smelled any of these either, so I just wanna give this one a sniff. Oh my goodness, bro. God damn it. This thing's like the Da Vinci Code, bro.
It really chopper.
También pendejo proof, because my dumbass couldn't open it.
Guys, don't mind if I do, but I'm gonna have to grab like a gram and a half just to taste this thing, man, because this is a 14 grammer, so it takes about an entire day to cure inside the device. If you were to get one of the smaller ones, you don't have to wait a whole entire day for it to cure, but you want it to cure because you want it to be nice and hard, like once you have it ready to go. So I'm gonna just say a gram and a half off to the side because I want to spark that up now. Sorry, I guess it's not a full 14 grammer. It doesn't matter. We're basically right around the corner from it. Ain't the end of the damn world. It's just the stoner in me, bro. I just gotta taste this fire. And I gotta taste it now.
They should change. Smoking weed and living high. I'm supposed to be the police. Don't say shit when they approach me. Different day, a different coast. I'm doing shit the way I'm supposed to. Flying private way from coach. Was a player, now I coach. 100 mil, I'm trying to gross. Roll a pound and float.
All right, man. Woo! The time has come. I gotta get my salt bay hands ready. You know, I just sprinkle a little bit in there. You feel me? So I low-key lost the first stick. I dropped it somewhere, but no problem. Good thing about my people over here is that they stack us up with a lot of them because they know how we stoners are, man. They prep for my damn ass, you know? So I'm gonna go ahead. Now we're gonna get this thing in. You wanna make sure, you guys, that this is closed, okay? So, like, you'll see right here it's open. That's when it opens up. That's what it looks like. But you wanna make sure it's nice and closed so that you don't mess this up. So you just kinda wanna pinch at this. You wanna pinch away. It is a process, okay? Be patient. Again, pointy side goes in, okay? So don't let that thing kick it in there. We're gonna get a pinch of some of this gas, some of this Zaza. We're gonna go ahead and just sprinkle it on top. Now the advice I got is, as you sprinkle it every time, you wanna compact it. Cause the more you compact it, like the tighter you make it, the faster it cures, and the longer it'll last. So just sprinkle a little tad bit up in there, and just take your time with it. Be patient, you know? Compress that thing.
That's what you still have. See, can't nobody take your spot. You don't miss me, you just missing out. I got you open off the words I spit. They tired of the rest, they need some gangster shit. See, I'm the best once the weed get lit. Don't leave your girl around me cause she might get hit. I rock Celine and all types of shit. At night we in the studio where mics get ripped. Doing my thing like a titan. These niggas mouth hurt from all the biking. Niggas soft, I ain't nothing like them. Don't need them. Say they my man, but I don't believe them. I'm getting...
Alright, y'all, so we're about almost at the end right here of our packing. And, yeah. It fit it really well. Again, the key, guys, is to pack it hard. Yeah, a little bit more, you guys. And we could have definitely fit the little gram and a half I took out. Because there's still space in this thing.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Ooh! So now this is the most tedious part, you guys. And hence why I pulled out like a gram and a half from it. Like I said in the beginning, since this is a 14 grammer, it takes about a day to cure for it to really get like hard. You know what I mean? So we're gonna let it cure. You don't need to put it nowhere. Don't put it in the fridge. Don't put it in the freezer. Just let it chill. I'm gonna let it chill right here next to my screen. So while I play Call of Duty, I'm gonna be looking over at it like, oh, you son of a bitch. Tomorrow, I'm gonna get you. Tomorrow, I shall smoke your ass. You know what I mean? Every time I kill somebody on Warzone, I'm gonna be like, yeah, bitch, I'm gonna smoke you. I smoke my Kanagar, motherfucking. Day two. And the mold is ready to go, and I'm just tipsy enough to get this thing rocking, you guys, man. Let's get it. So the mold is good, you guys. I'm gonna show you guys what it looks like. I'm gonna just go ahead, pop it open right here, bust that bad boy open, and here you have it. Now I actually like compacted this a lot, so it almost looks like we're not doing the entire, well, I think at the end of it, it was like 13 grams, like 12 and a half, because I took like a gram and a half out to smoke. But this is just really, really compacted, which I recommend you guys really compact it, because the more you compact it, the longer it's going to burn. So I'm going to go ahead and just pull this bad boy out. Just going to be gentle with it, kind of pick at it from like both sides here. Boom. Now, guys, you want to roll this as fast as you can. once you open it, just because it does start to uncompress because it's no longer in there like super tight, right? So I have my leaf right here. Originally, I was debating whether I should use like a backwood or not, but the reason I ended up not going with the backwood was because I don't think the backwood would be big enough for all of this. So I'm gonna just go ahead and I'm gonna cut my leaf, kind of just shape it like the best I can. And I'm gonna cut it right now to like more of an adjustable size. So I'm gonna just go ahead, I'm gonna put my flower down. I'm gonna see if I can roll it there. I might have to tuck it in a little bit more. Actually, I have to tuck it in a lot more just because the end over here. Okay, cool. So I'm gonna just roll around my whole entire product, right? Like this. Go ahead, just lick and roll. Lick and roll. Lick and roll. Lick and roll. There's like a little stem right there that wasn't letting it go down. So I'm just ripping off that stem. So now that I got my entire product rolled, I'm gonna go ahead and just like gently pull the stick out. Now you gotta be really careful with this part because you don't wanna break it by like bending the stick as you pull it out. Now there's two ends to this. One end is flat and one end is rounded. So you actually want the rounded end so that you can put like your mouthpiece on there. The rounded end is on this side right here. But we're gonna go ahead, actually I have a little lighter right here. I'm just gonna kind of burn off like the excessive paper, excessive leaf, I'm sorry. So use the same paper. You don't need all this excess here. I don't have scissors or else like ideally I would just cut this part off with scissors, you know? Now on this end here, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna apply the filter to it. Now my recommendation, guys, is that you kind of like, it's almost like you don't just shove it in only. You're kind of doing these light twists. It's like you're going side to side. It's not a full twist, but it's just enough of a twist so that you can like push it in there. But you gotta be very careful because you don't want to snap it, you know? So I'm just going around in a circle here. I got my filter in, okay? And now this thing is ready to burn. On this end here, I'm gonna just go ahead, I'm gonna twist it up. Just like that, you guys, I rolled myself a Canagar. Now we're gonna spark this up. I am gonna set a timer to see how long it takes to burn. Like I said, this thing's about 12 grams and a half because I did take some out of it. So we're gonna see how long it takes to burn, but I am gonna have the homie Francisco come and join me on this sesh. He's actually been behind the camera this whole time, so shout out to the homie El Tricone. He's gonna go ahead and get in front of the camera with me. We're gonna spark this thing up and we're gonna time it. We're gonna see how long it takes to burn, man. Let's get it, man. Destroy a like button.
What's popping, my boy?
What's up, my bro?
You ready for this or what?
Let's get it, bro.
Is this your first Canagar?
This is
my first Canagar as well.
Holy fuck, it sure looks like a Cubano fucking cigar.
It looks like a cigar, huh?
Yeah.
It does look like a cigar, man. So we're gonna go ahead, we'll get this thing sparked. Now, I recommend you guys spark it up with a torch, you know, it's the best way to do it. Cause it is very thick, it's very compact, so like a lighter might not be the most ideal way. So we're gonna go ahead and use our handy dandy torch right here. We got the stopwatch starting now. So let's see how long this bad boy burns for, man.
Damn, bro.
What's up with you, bro? How was work, man?
It was good, bro. Shit was fucking... I had this one customer, bro. Fuck, dude. That dude just kept asking the same question like 3 times. You know, I learned patience at my job, bro.
Again, like these grown-ass
adults. All the grown-ass motherfuckers, adults, bro. 40-year-olds, bro. Homeowners. I tell them the same thing like 10 times about how we can't fit something in a certain way in their kitchen. They just don't listen, bro. Wanna go around it.
Well, homie, he does like custom cabinets and stuff like that for people's kitchens.
Yeah, but it was good, bro. Good day, good day.
This is about to get better right now. Shit.
Yeah, this cherry looks freaking crazy, bro.
Yeah, it's like a, it looks like a fucking Crayola, bro. Looks like a crayon. Que vamos a escribir algo.
See the airflow on this bad boy.
We're about to be little heralds in the purple crayon right now.
Ooh.
Fire? Bro, which trains were in there again? Run it right back to me again. Run it right back to me again.
It's from Mount Vernon. Okay. Right? I think that's the
Mount Vernon. Mount Vernon. Yeah. Mount Vernon.
Shout out to my local Dispo as well for hooking me up with the trains.
Shout out to Dispo.
And this was like a $280 half ounce.
Holy fuck.
Yes.
What the fuck? So we're smoking $280?
Yes.
What the fuck? Why'd you roll it all up like that?
Well, I figured if we're gonna do something, it had to be epic. You know what I'm saying?
Let's fucking go, bro. You always do fucking bangers. Look at this shit.
Wow.
Oh my god.
Airflow is impeccable. It is crazy because, like, I'm ripping it hard, but I don't really feel it moving much. It's, like,
is it smooth? How's the drag? How's the pull?
Fire, bro. Much.
I said drag. How's the pull? Wow. Wow. I don't know if I'm ready for this shit right here.
This is a lung buster, bro.
Grab it from where I want to fuck anything up. The tip,
maybe,
huh?
That's good, yeah.
Maybe the tip, huh? More secure. I hate for it. Bro.
It has a very sturdy tip, so...
Bro.
You can grab it from there. I was actually able to really fit it into the mouthpiece in there.
Wow.
It's like very crazy to me how it just doesn't burn down like a regular blunt or regular joint. It's just automatic, like you hit it and you start seeing like the blunt burn down. You know what I'm saying? That's crazy, you guys. That's mind blown to me. Definitely the slowest burn you're ever gonna get with anything you roll right here, you know?
Bro, this shit just tastes amazing. Oh my god.
Bro. That's crazy. It's almost like somehow, like, I don't know, obviously there's science to like compacting your flour in there, but that's pretty mind blown to me.
No, there's definitely like, should I get science behind this? They didn't just stumble across this. It should require some thought, you know? Damn. I should have my nose so bad.
Mm-hmm. I feel like this is perfect for like when you have multiple people you're like burning it with, especially with like a blunt. Cause you know how like people tend to like put their mouth on it in a certain way where they're like squeezing it and kind of like closing out the airflow to it? Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Ah, mm-hmm. Oh, damn, bro.
Wow.
You know, this shit just got me wondering. The motherfuckers that smoke cigars must have some lungs, cause.
Yeah, this kind of like is the closest thing to a cigar I can imagine, bro.
Like, yo.
Shout out Purple Rose Supply, man. This is fire, you guys.
Shout out Purple Rose Supply. Fuck.
Jesus. I'm off like the end of this classic lime Corona as well. Cheers to everybody watching, man. Make sure you guys comment down below. Let me know where you guys are watching from. But I want to like maybe give them a couple story times since like this is probably gonna be a lengthy video. Yeah. I'm assuming this thing's gonna take a while to burn down, you guys. But you wanna tell them about the first time I ever got you high?
Oh, I'd hate for it to happen again, but I dropped the fucking joint.
Oh my god.
Can I just drop this right now? Oh my god.
Don't say that. Not even Jinx dropping that right now. But you wanna tell them a little bit about it? Kinda how it went down and stuff?
Yeah. So, it was fucking fourth period, right before lunch, right?
I think it was during lunch.
It was, but we were in the period before lunch talking about it.
Right.
We were in the period before lunch talking about it. I don't know, third, fourth, fifth, who knows? Talking, you were like, so you're gonna smoke weed, right? You've been saying this since yesterday, you're gonna try it today. Today's the day, so you ready for lunch or what? And I'm like, nah, honestly, bro, I don't think I really wanna do it no more. What the fuck? And I'm like, what? You're like, bro, you're gonna smoke. I'm like, bro, it's just like my mom. She's like, how's your mom gonna know? I'm like, well, bro, it's like, That's gonna smell. Bro, you got class for like the next 3 hours, 4 hours. You're not gonna smell when you go home. I'm like, damn, bro, what if I just get caught or something? You're like, you're with me, how are you gonna get caught? I'm like, fuck. I'm like, where are we gonna smoke again? You're like, bro, across the street at the fucking fountain. I'm like, bro, my neighbor hangs there, bro. Brian, you're like, Gangster Brian? Yeah, bro, Gangster Brian. Bro, Gangster Brian's gonna snitch on you? You tell me Gangster Brian's about to let his mom to tell your mom that you went and smoked weed at the fountain? I'm like, Gangster Brian's about to be a snitch, bro. He's really about to do this shit. He's about to. You're like, nah, you're fucking stupid. You're smoking, Chesco. There's no question about it.
I really peer pressure.
Yeah. And I was like, bro, I'm like, well, let me get lunch. Was, yeah, you're going to get lunch. You're going to get hungry, so you got to get lunch. I'm like, all right, but I'm trying to stall. I'm like, all right. So class ends, we go through fucking pass and go straight to the cafeteria and we get our lunch. You're like, all right, bro, let's go. And we walk across the street, bro. And I'm thinking,
literally across the street.
We walk across. No, you're right, bro.
I'm in control.
Literally across the fucking street.
Yeah, bro, like. Just imagine walking across your house to go smoke for
this
the first time.
To this day amazes me. Let me tell you why we smoked across the street from the high school. So there was this, when the school first started, there was this rule that we thought that if, this is why we went across. If we were across the street, we were off school grounds. Therefore, they can't do anything to us. That was why we were there.
Really?
That's why people smoked at the fountain with such balls right in front of the school.
They would just smoke there.
Because they said, that's off campus, so we can do whatever the fuck we want. Literally. And I was thinking there the whole time, I'm like, bro, why are we smoking across the street? We're going to get caught? And you're like, bro, everyone smokes here. This is off campus. You can't get told anything. You literally said that to me, and I'm like, that makes sense. That makes sense. Yeah, we're off campus, bro. We're smoking weed.
We're good.
We're good, bro. It's off campus. So I'm thinking with my head, oh shit, it's good. Shit's clicking. Okay. So we start walking and I'm still nervous and I hear, where's the lighter? Bro, I didn't bring a lighter. And you start asking the little group of friends we had walking towards the fountain. I think it was Brandon. And they remember Brandon, that one dude?
I don't remember his name.
His name's Brandon. That Mexican dude that was like white Mexican.
But I remember specifically looking around like, yo, you got a lighter? And I got us a lighter.
Yeah, you fucking, basically, I heard there was no lighter and you start saying, no one brought a lighter. I'm thinking, fuck yes, I'm safe. I'm not smoking today. I'm like, yes.
Were you really paranoid?
I was so paranoid. I didn't want to do this shit no more. I was at this point, I didn't want to do it no more, but I was there.
What do you think was the biggest thing you were scared of?
My mom. What do you mean? What else? I was like 15. What else? Like my mom.
You were like 14.
No, bro. Cause like my mom's about to find out. My dad's about to. What if they send me to like some drug program, thinking I'm a drug addict? What if my mom goes through a depression now? That I was so much stupid shit was going through my head that day.
You're thinking of the worst.
I mean, you're 15. You start thinking about stupid shit. You know, more of my mom's feelings. You know. So I'm there like, oh, I'm not gonna get to smoke. They got no lighter. We can't light this without a lighter.
Yes!
Literally a fucking stoner ass dude. We'll go lighter.
I'm like, bro, no! That was God like, I got you.
I got you, Bob. Hold on just a second. We got you. And I was like, bro. And then literally he starts lighting it up. We walk a little bit down the trail from the fountain. There's a little bit of a pathway down the fountain. And there we are. So fucking get the lighter out. And he just starts lighting it up. And I'm like, bro. I'm like, is it harsh? You're like, nah, bro. All you're gonna do is just put it up to your mouth and just hit that shit. Just hit that shit. I'm like, all right, there I go, bro. I take my first fucking hit. I cough so fucking hard that shit drops. I'm like, fuck, dude. And you're like, what are you doing? I'm like, bro, I didn't mean to. Why the fuck did you drop it? That shit turns off, bro. You get pissed.
It just like that, it wasn't lit no more, you know? So we couldn't hit it no more. And this guy gave us a lighter, like left.
Yeah.
Like, he gave us a lighter, we lit it, we gave it back, and he just walked away. So, like, I was like, bro, we couldn't smoke it no more. It was like halfway through still, you know? But we couldn't take a half lit roach back to school.
Yeah.
And just have it in our backpack or something like that. Like, we didn't have containers, nothing, bro. So, I'm gonna give you guys the end of like how I did it. How I even got the weed that day.
How did you?
I remember the homie, I'm not gonna drop his name specifically, but I remember it starts with an S.
Oh.
And an S and an E. Oh. That fool, he would like sell his tree. So I remember I went up to him, acting like I do this all the time, because at the time I was still pretty new to like getting lit, like, you know?
But I was like, yo, what's up, bro? And they got like $10. I think it was like $10. And I was like, $10. I asked my dad for $10 for pizza after school.
Oh, no way.
Which after I got caught by them, my dad was like, is that why you asked me for food for money for pizza? I was like, no.
You're like, no, pa.
Like, that was exactly why I was asking for money for pizza.
Damn, but the finesse you have to go through the kids.
But remember getting the $10, I gave it to him. I'll be right back. He goes into the school cafeteria bathroom. There was a bathroom in there. Did you ever notice? You remember where they were selling like
the little right in front, stuff right inside? Right in front, huh?
No, inside of the cafeteria. You know that little part where they would sell the expensive stuff where you would have to have money?
Yeah.
And then like right there, right in front of that, there was a bathroom. It was literally inside there. I'd actually never seen it till that day.
Really?
Because I just never paid attention to it. It's like off to the side, inside on the corner.
And there it was locked or some shit?
It was just an open bathroom.
Bruh.
Like an all gender bathroom or something like that. But for like one person at a time. So you can go in there and lock the door.
Damn.
So he went into the bathroom, locked the door, and he rolled up a J. And he came out, probably like a 0.5 or something, like looking back at it. Because how much money can you make off $10 to roll something and sell it, you know?
Yeah.
Got skimmed. But like, you know, he did it, he rolled it for us, and then that's it. I just took the J and I remember thinking, this is perfect because I don't really know how to roll yet. I just want to light it and smoke it, you know?
Yeah.
And yeah, that's how I came across the tree.
I wonder where you got the weed that day. Mm-hmm. I was wondering where we got the herb that day.
So we had no container. I couldn't just like throw it in a container and take the roach with us and be like, I'll light this later.
No wonder you were so persistent on getting to the fucking fountain. Because it was reeking, huh?
Yeah, and we had a time frame, like.
That's right, the time frame. I forget we're in school.
By the way, guys, I continue to lick this clothes, but it's not the, it's me. It's like the way I rolled it. There's like a huge fat stem, and long story short, like, just to let you guys know, because I'm sure you guys are watching me like, why does this dude keep licking the blood? But yeah, so I had no container to put it back in.
Bro.
So I was like, oh, I have no choice, but so we're done. Like, we left it. I think we squashed. You know what, remember? Didn't one of the campus security guards like come by? On the golf cart. Remember that?
They were
like, not long after we finished. They came through in the golf cart.
In the same trail we were at.
In this, right, they pulled up on us basically.
Yeah, from behind.
But we're already done. Like, we had already thrown it out and everything. So low key, looking back at it, we got hella lucky that like it went out. Cause if it didn't go out, we would have still been puffing and they would have got us right there, bro. First day, you getting lit. Everything you were fearing was gonna come to life.
Oh my god.
They would have called your mom. Your mom would have came, pulled you from the school, probably got suspended. It would have been like,
oh man, my mom would have thought it would have been a fuck up. Kerry, they thought it was a fuck up when they kicked me out from the bar.
So, yeah, dude, I just remember getting this full lit for the first time, and ever since then, you've been a stoner.
Yeah, I didn't look back. Well, someone did, because I ain't gonna lie, at first, I wasn't with the whole going up to someone and buying weed. I just couldn't get past those. What if I get caught buying weed? But then I started telling myself, I'm underage. They're gonna get in trouble for selling it to me. And I was like, nah, it's good. No, I didn't think like that. Honestly, I was just like, fuck it. I gotta smoke my weed.
I remember my parents asked me, like, where do you get weed from? And I was like, some guy outside of school. Made some bullshit up.
The guy in my class.
I didn't say that. I was like, some guy wants me to go in there and be like, some guy from his class sold it to him.
Oh my god, bro. That was honestly like my worst fear, that like my parents would come to the school and put me in that drug. Remember they had that drug program?
Dare? Oh, it wasn't Dare, but it was like the concept of Dare. Like legit, like a therapist almost, I guess, type thing, where they would talk to you about like, how much do you smoke? Why do you smoke? Or what drugs you're doing and how much of it you take and all that shit.
Yeah. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah, I remember that shit. Yeah, that was the first time getting this full lit. And I just remember, like, him being paranoid and shit. And we went back to the school and he was actually so paranoid. Because there was, like, this guy wearing, like, those jerseys. Like, you know, like, the ones the football players wear, were like, what are they called? Letterman
jackets?
Letterman jackets or whatever. He was wearing that, and this fool thought I was a security guard by the water fountain. He wanted water. He's like, there's a security guard by the water fountain. And I was like, dude, that's not a security. He's like, no, that's a security. And he's like tripping out. And I just remember, like, I kept laughing because I was like, that's not a security guard.
I was like, there's not a bad comment, bro. Dead ass, dry ass mouth.
Like something I never experienced.
Gotta drink water right now, please.
Yeah, I remember that, bro. And, well, anyways, like, long story short, he didn't drink water. He was all tripped out, and, like, that was his first time getting lit.
I was ever going to classes hella high. I remember the whole time I was thinking, this is how Wiz Khalifa must feel, bro. That's really good. That was the only person I looked up to that smoked. I was like, whoa, that's how he must feel, bro.
Dude, it's crazy, and I don't think people, unless they're our age, will ever understand that. Well, maybe that's how they look at, like, yeah, me and people that do like what I do.
Yeah.
But like I remember, like, at that age, yeah, 15, 14, to us, Wiz was like a mega star, like, cause he was popping, like everybody was listening to him. It's like right now people listen to like Lil Baby and like Lil Uzi Vert, like that. Back then people were listening to Wiz Khalifa, and like,
yeah,
it was in style, it was trending and shit, like, you know.
He was popping.
So I feel like yeah, I used to think the same thing when I would get lit. I'd be like, is this how Wiz feels like?
Right.
I used to think, like, how does he do this all day?
Yeah, how is he productive?
How does he get shit done? Like, I can't get shit done when I'm fucking lit all day. Like, that's back in the days when you really get lit. You know what I mean? Like,
that's one thing I was thinking too. Like, what the fuck?
I remember the first time I put him on, putting Doritos into sandwiches. This man had never put Doritos into a sandwich. But you know, my high ass had already done that shit.
We had gotten high from... That day we got high behind my my house with the fucking magnifying glass and the
Oh my god, didn't the house smell or something like that, and we're like tripping out? Or did we go to the train tracks?
We went to the train tracks.
Oh, okay. I remember one time we smoked in that little like balcony thing you have to
fill outside,
like the house reek, and we're like tripping out.
Yeah,
huh? We're like right next to the door, like what do we fucking expect to happen, you know?
No, we're fucking stupid.
Yeah, like, exactly. So it just kind of like, we were dumb for that one, but yeah, I remember that. That shit was funny. Wow. Dude, this one time this fool came to my crib, right? And we got lit in my crib. And again, this is back in like when we were first ever getting lit. So like we would just go to sleep. We would like go through all the high people's shit, eat the munchies, go to sleep, like everything, trip out for a little bit.
Fucking giggles.
Yeah, all that. And I remember we were super baked. And at this time, both of my parents were work. So, I would have the house to myself, like on a Saturday. I think it was a Saturday, too, it was a weekend.
Yeah, huh?
This fool came over, we got fucking lit in the backyard, like we're chilling, you know, we came back inside. And then I was super high, so I have these two couches and I wanna go lay on the couch. He was like, yo, I'm hella hungry, like, can I make some food? And I was like, yeah, bro. I was like, a ton of food in the freezer. Like, go at it. You know, like the shit you throw in the fucking microwave. And I'm laying down, bro. And all I hear is, bro, how do you turn this thing on? I'm like, what's the microwave like? Dee dee dee. You know what I mean? 3, 4 buttons, dog.
You said, damn, this is gonna be hard. Let me go figure this one out.
And I was like, alright, it's cool. I'm the guest. I shouldn't be laying down. So I got up. I walked over there. I see this man. This is no cop, bro. Like, this is for real how I went down. I see this man by the stove with a plate, like a plate that, you know, you would put your food on and throw in the microwave on the fucking stove.
A glass plate
on the stove with an entire, like, packaging of the burritos, the ones you freeze, the ones in the purple bag.
Two hot pockets, that, like, two hot pockets up in
and two hot pockets that were still in the plastic. All on top of this plate, on top of the stove. And I was like,
I was trying to turn the stove on.
No, you don't light the fucking house on fire, dog. He was trying to turn the stove on. I'm glad he didn't know how to turn the stove on. Because later he told me, like, you know, my parents don't like to touch the stove. And I was like, why not? Almost set the house on fire. So now it all makes sense. You want some water? I gotta get water. The cotton mouth is starting to kick. You know, actually, matter of fact, let me see. I'm bringing you a cup real quick.
No, it's good.
I got you. We shall resume this. Hold on, man. Yeah, so my advice, if you're gonna smoke one of these, have nothing to do for a cool 2 hours, bro, because.
Minimum. Dude, it looks like it's got a little donut vibe to it. Like if you put hash in there.
That's exactly what it looks like.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Oh god.
Wow. I'm very impressed with this. Fuck. I feel like how even when we smoke the big 14 gram joints that look huge and stuff like that,
yeah,
they don't burn like for that long.
And not just that, they're unsatisfying to hit.
Yeah, you're hitting it and you're just like your throat's aching, like you're going through it, you know?
Well, I'm gonna be honest with you. You're right about that. Like those fucking big ass half ounce joints, like you have to really like, ugh.
Like you have to pull so hard on it, bro.
Yeah, not, yeah, and it just doesn't feel enjoyable. It feels like too much smoke in you.
Yeah. And you're trying so hard to not just hit it. It's basically a mission to like say the least. And I feel like this is just so much more enjoyable and just easy to do. And it's way more like practical to roll, or I guess to like stuff and roll and stuff. It's really hard to roll a 14 gram joint, a 14 gram blunt, like when it's this freaking big, you know?
Don't you feel like also when you do that, like, the resin or whatever the fuck you call it, like the residue, like just like on the fucking before the tip, it just accumulates like motherfucker.
Yeah, but when it's all over your lips, huh? Start getting like super, super sticky and shit.
Oh, you get that nasty ass taste. But with this, it's tolerable, it's enjoyable. They made a product that helps you smoke a big amount of weed like this, you know?
And there's different sizes to it as well, you guys. Like I said, this one's the one that's meant for like 14 grams. However, as you can tell, I believe we can fit more. We probably fit like 15, 16 in here. Just like, it all depends how much you compact it. Because if you don't compact it enough, it will look bigger on the 14 grams. If you're really hard on it, it looks a little smaller. I compacted it like 2 or 3 times just to kind of get a feel for it because I wanted to understand it, you know what I mean? And each time I did compact it, it was like a day that you wait to cure. But that's because this is the larger size one. There are smaller sizes where you don't have to wait an entire day for it to cure. But I went with the bigger one, and I would say like this is perfect for like a party. If you're at a party, bro, and you're about to stash with like 10 of your homies.
Oh. Fuck. This
you pull this bad well. And if you hotbox with this, good luck to you. You might need like an ambulance afterwards because you're gonna be in there for so long. We're already 24 minutes and 23 seconds into it.
This is insane. We're finishing it?
Homie's like, we have to finish this thing, bro? We're gonna try to get through this, bro. Even us, OG stoners, bro. We've been in this for the long run, man. And like, this is not easy, you know what I'm saying? This is definitely a lengthy smoke, to say the least.
You know what's funny that you said that OG stoners? We're such OG stoners that we've been smoking back before it was cool when fucking people, like,
I ain't gonna name names.
People, certain people in our group.
Yeah.
People that know smoke now a lot. Well, look, they turn into some potheads. I remember just hearing that one and thinking, like, fuck you.
Yeah, I remember people looking at us like, we just want shit. We weren't gonna be nothing in life, like, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I remember, bro. I remember back then people. But now look at them. Everyone's smoking ganja, bro. Everyone loves this.
What's funny is, like, I get DMs now from people in high school, like, yo, dude, I be smoking your shit. And I'm like, you smoke weed? Like, what?
What? You were the most uptight motherfucker I ever knew.
Like, that's dope. But that's how you know weed is so universal now and shit, you know? It's not like it used to be, like,
right.
We were around when it was very taboo.
Yeah, huh?
It was hella taboo. It's almost like you didn't even talk about weed.
Yeah.
Like, the whole subject of it was like, we don't talk about it, ah, no veo nada, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
So I think it was definitely hard for our parents to accept it, because, like, it wasn't normal for them and like, their time growing up. For that was a bad thing.
It seemed like crap.
Yeah, bro, it seemed like a real drug, like, a hard drug, like, something that'll like ruin your life or something, or like, I wouldn't say that's what happened at all.
Nowhere near that, bro. You know, like, it's by far, you know what I mean? If anything, bro, it's done a complete 360, like, it's been accepted nationally, you know, praised as a medicine. It's crazy, bro. It's crazy how far it's come since we graduated high school.
Bro, it was crazy because I remember being in high school and just thinking like, this shit's gonna be big one day, like.
Yeah.
I remember thinking even back then, I was like, this has so much future.
Like, it's just starting, you know? It's just people are going to take a while to accept it. And I think it's the same thing with tattoos right now. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
Let's just say, like, one out of every, like, I don't know, 20,000 people might have a neck tattoo. So, like, but I think, in, like, the next 10, 20 years, it's going to be very different. Because now it's even, like, I'm not saying people should do it or whatever, but I feel like even face tattoos have became, like, a common factor in,
so
like,
normalized.
Younger people and shit like that, you know what I mean?
I'm gonna be real with you, bro. When I was growing up, if I see someone with a face tattoo, I immediately thought the most hardcore motherfucker, you're insane, bro. You've done time. You've killed a few people. You got bodies under your name. I don't even have to talk to you. I just know that.
Mm-hmm.
Now it's like, no.
No,
it's just art. Yeah, it's like, you know? It's always been that way. It's just the way we.
How do you feel like you view me with the now since like I didn't have it before? How was it at first? Be real. When you first saw my full neck tat, and we're walking around in public, and like you would just see people staring at us. And all
bro,
that.
I mean, I'm not gonna lie to you. All I would think of was just how much. Why did he go put himself into so much pain? I couldn't comprehend why you did it. I mean, I'll be real with you. It looks dope. I know. Your whole life since we were in high school, I'm going to tattoo my whole body. Like, I'm like, nah.
Yo, look, facts right there. That's a fact right there. I've been saying this since I was like 14, 15.
Yeah, I'm going to tattoo my whole body. I'm like, everything we get. And I was like, you're crazy. I thought you were always bullshitting. But, you know, now I've seen you done all the way up to here. And you even say you're going to complete that and then finish off. I was like, nah, fuck, you're right. He's definitely gonna do everything, bro.
Oh, bro.
And then, like, I've now seen how many pieces you've got over time, and it's like, yeah, it's like halfway already done, so it's like, it's not much, you know? I know you can bear through it, just do the rest.
Yeah.
I know it's gonna come to reality. But it's crazy that I've known you since the time where no tattoos, nothing, and you would always just talk about having a shit ton of tattoos. And it just happened over time. And it's not like you went out of your way and were like, come look at him right now, but like, it just happened, like, over, and I was like, holy shit, I'm gonna get this one, I'm gonna get that one. Everybody look at this new one. And it's like, fuck, that's crazy. I honestly, when you got it, I was just thinking like, damn, that's crazy, you really did this shit. Really did. I'm like, I'll always look at that and I'll be like, bro, right on the Adam's up, when I poke at my Adam's up, I'm like, ooh, nah,
dude,
I can't do that, bro.
I took some shrooms and I was like looking in the mirror and I was like, damn, I really get a lot of tattoos. Like, touching my tattoos, I was like all tripped out. I was like, wow. Like, I was just so amazed by them, bro. I was asking myself, like, do these hurt? You know? I was lit, bro. But, like, yeah, I a lot of people stare at me everywhere I go, which I know. I mean, like, I would stare too if somebody had a full neck, like, sleeve, basically, you know?
Yeah.
But, like, I forget I have it.
You do?
Yeah, all the time. If people were staring at me and I just completely forget I have that.
Until you see a reflection?
Yeah, I take a picture or something and I'm like, oh yeah, I'll hold my, like, tat, like, what?
I have a question for you. Nah. Do you, like, miss having no tattoos?
No.
No, huh? It was boring, huh?
Because I remember my mom told me one time, what girl's gonna watch you with all those tattoos? And each one of them.
Each one of them.
And I'm not gonna say just girls, but I'm just saying, like, I mean, like, I'm not gonna say that's the only reason that I don't miss, like, not having here girls, not having tattoos. But, like, you know, I feel like, I don't know, bro. I always wanted to do it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So it was like, imagine, like, I feel like, I don't know, this is my opinion. But I feel like guys getting tattoos, like, a lot of tattoos, etc., it's almost like the equivalent of, like, a BBL on a girl. Like, you see a girl with the BBL and you stare multiple times, you admire her, you're kind of like, you might talk some shit, that ass is fake, it don't look right, but you will catch yourself, like, you know, looking back at it. So it's like, it's the same thing I feel like with the tattoos. It's like, a good portion of people might say, oh, that's ugly, like, ugh.
Yeah.
But then, like, there's a good portion of people that are also, at some point, they're admiring it. It's kind of like, especially with the girls. Though, you know, they fuck with it. I feel like it's an easy conversation starter. I feel like it's something I always wanted to do. So, like, fuck just how people view it, you know? But
yeah, right?
But yeah, it's always something I wanted, bro. I just thought it was so cool, you know, ever since I was young. But I don't miss not having them.
No?
No. But I would say, like,
I don't know. It's weird. Sometimes I think like, oh, if I didn't have them, I could go do like this, like be a lawyer, or I could go. But I think I can still do it. It's really not stopped, and I feel like we're in a different time where like, yeah, if my work speaks for me, people are gonna come back.
Yeah, like.
Does that make sense? Like,
that's what I was thinking too. It's gonna get to a point where like you're gonna have a lawyer with the neck tattoo in like 20 years.
The younger people are gonna grow up, and they're normalized to it.
Yeah.
They're not like the older people of right now.
Us, yeah.
So when, you know, like let's say a 40-year-old lawyer now, when I'm 40, and there's people our age,
yeah,
they're gonna look at me like the cool lawyer.
Yeah.
And I wanna go with that guy, like, you know what I mean? Like,
he probably knows the legal system better than anyone.
Yeah, he looks like somebody who's, I don't know, but, and then just plus like the work and like maybe me, like, that all kind of just comes together from there, like, you know?
Yeah, like, it isn't gonna be normal. It seems like these are gonna get accepted, you know?
Yeah, so I don't regret not having them, or I don't miss not having them, or whatever. Like, I wanna get more.
He said, we'll get more.
They're just so expensive, bro. I spent like, fucking, like, somebody's like car on my neck, basically, you know what I mean?
That part, bro, like,
they're like, I go with good artists, and like, it's not cheap, so.
No, hell no.
It's not cheap, that's it, you know what I mean? I could've, like, I'll tell you this, I could've bought myself a chain, a bust down chain, and a bust down Rolex, why not? Like, the tattoos I paid for and shit. So, yeah, they're not cheap, man, I'll tell you guys that. And right now, you guys, we are, how far into this, man? 33 minutes, bro.
Fuck.
Probably around like 30-40% done.
God damn. Bro, aren't tattoos in LA like more expensive?
It's not just LA, it's kind of like.
Is it because it's like congested with all the good tattoo artists down there?
No, what? It's just good tattoo artists. Because I've seen some people like in Australia or like different places of the world, bro, that are like some of the most expensive tattoo artists.
Oh.
Yeah, but their skills are just like whoosh, like, you know?
Like that level.
Way like more advanced than this, bro. Like, you would look at it and it's like you're looking at like a reflection of like an image, like a real image, like in the sense of like they do color really, really well. And I think color brings a tattoo to a different kind of life in a way.
Really?
Hell yeah, bro. Like the right color, especially like on a light tone like you, like pops, is so crazy. I'm gonna have to show you some of the, those, like,
yeah.
Yeah, oh, I would throw some on the screen.
I like, fuck with, honestly, if I really get tattoos, I'd get no color. I wouldn't. Like, I like the shading.
You have a good skin tone, though, for color.
Color?
Yeah, like, if you did color, like, it would look right on you, you know? But, yeah, I don't know. This was as he's gonna get a tattoo, like, all the time, and then when it comes down to, he's like, nah, I don't want it.
Ball, we go for Christmas and get it down there.
Christmas?
Yeah, we go.
All right, we're gonna hold it to that, guys. 10,000 likes! Tell 10,000 likes, Francisco.
Mm-hmm. I don't want to say 1,000 likes on this.
Well, you already agreed on.
Alright, 10,000 likes
on this. And a Christmas, you'll get a tattoo.
I'll get a tattoo.
I need you guys to just die. Log into 20 YouTube accounts and hit the like button. Create a couple and go hit the like button on this one.
Nah, but imagine it does.
Get this man a tattoo. Dun dun dun. Dude, your mom's gonna be like, no! It's way too much time.
Oh, fuck, imagine. Nah, dude. You know what's the dope part about? That if I do get a tattoo, my boss is so fucking dope and chill, it wouldn't matter. I can literally go through to my job with the next glass of like yours and he wouldn't give a fuck.
Yeah, well, you're already good at your job. They don't care, like, they know you're gonna still be good at your job, you know?
Oh, yeah.
So, like, that's what I'm telling you. I don't think tattoos are gonna be that important in, like, the big, like, long run of it.
Yeah.
Like, all I think employers care about is that you perform.
Yes.
He performed the task of the job,
yes,
and you do it well.
Yes. You're right.
They don't care if you're a guy and you go get yourself boobs. Like, you know that. You're good at your job? Congratulations. You're fucking hired. Like,
you're hired.
We live in a different time, bro.
We do. Mmm. God. If you're good at something, don't matter, bro. Image.
So yeah, your skills, you know, how much effort and work you put into things or whatever, like, that's how I look at it. Now, I know the older people might be like, no, it's not, but I don't know, bro, we're switching, times are getting different, like, you know, the old people mindset isn't going to be around forever.
Mm-hmm. They would say some bullshit like that.
Yeah, because older people are more scared, it wasn't part of their time, bro, like,
yeah, so
would you see a 50-year-old with a full neck blasted, like,
no. But you know what I am seeing now? 50-year-olds with sleeves and whole shit, you're blasting.
Yeah. Like, they broke into that part of it. And now there's people like me
Yeah. They're like, you know,
doing the neck. But then when we're 60, when we're 60 years old, you know?
The young kids, bro, watch. We're going to be thinking they're crazy with like the crazy ass face tats. Like the young kids are going to have like, that's why, like, I already know it's going to happen. It's already happening. But like right now people are getting small face tats, like something really small, like small, you know what I mean? But it's going to get like, Wayne did his whole face kind of, like a lot of small tats. But then people are going to get big ones. Like the way people do sleeves, the way people do all that shit, people are gonna get big ass fucking face tats.
Oh God. I can't imagine, bro. Would you?
I could be like, oh, I said I was never gonna get a face tat, and like, I guess this is kind of a face tat. It is a face tat.
Oh, it is, yeah.
Right? Yeah. Or is it a sideburn tat?
No. You might be able to get away with that.
What'd you think? Face tat?
50-50. On the, that's you.
I know, that's right.
On the bad worst case scenario, yeah, I guess face tap. Depends who you're asking though, honestly. It's like stuff, but people, they say it's a face tap.
Okay.
You ask me, it's a side, it's
damn it, kind of counting part of your neck.
Counting part of your neck?
Yeah, a lot of neck. You a giraffe. You a giraffe.
Much, it just like,
dude, like we've been forever. I'm so tired.
I'm stoned. I'm tired.
There's definitely a good like 2-3 days smoke, bro.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Maybe even more. Like if you don't consume that much, you know what I mean.
If you don't consume that much, it's just gonna last you a lifetime.
I feel like, you know what, this could be good for too. Like even people that don't smoke that much, that just want to stretch out like their product.
Yeah,
but like you get the 2 or 4 gram size one, you pound it down, you roll it hella easy, boom, last you a couple days.
You know what? It's like a fucking Cuban cigar, literally.
Yeah,
you gonna go ahead, you grab this Cuban cigar clipper, you clip this when you're done, it's fresh. Next day, you relight the bitch smoke, clip it again.
Yeah.
I think you can really go through with that like this. You know?
You clip it. Yeah, right, you just clip it where you finish, it, where you set up.
Yeah, tomorrow you spark greens.
And it is more of a cigar experience, guys. Maybe you guys, I mean, I feel like there's gonna be a couple comments like, you didn't hear
me be hit. You don't got lungs. But you see, if I was in there right now in that hot box, I would have smoked it all in 1 second.
Here's the one rip.
It's because these aren't real smokers.
But it's like, it is like more of a cigar experience. You almost kind of have to puff at it.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
You know what I mean? Like, it's a cigar experience, bro. It's very packed. It's not the same airflow like you get from like just a regular roll. You gotta puff at it. And it's you're here for a long time, bro.
You are. Gotta have lungs.
Yeah, not just that. You're not gonna do a fucking hour. You just gotta, you know what I mean?
Yeah, on your own cap. Like, I mean, bro, we've been doing half-ounce fucking joints since like 2016, bro. Let's be real here, bro. 2016.
I got no one to impress with your bitch ass.
Bro, we're doing this. Me, you, Diego type shit, bro. Back in the G35 type shit, bro. Like, that's how far I've come with this shit. In the coupe, bro. In the coupe. I'm in the backseat, bro. Like, I'm telling you, like, we have lungs, bro. And this shit is going for days. This is enough for 10 people, honestly, to have a great session.
Just kicking my ass, bro.
And you're gonna be stoned out of your fucking mind even with 10 people hitting
you. To be fair, I guess we are smoking 14 grams, but still, I ain't never took this long to smoke 14 grams in one roll.
Nah, bro. No. I mean, no, there's no way.
Guys, I'm high out of my fucking mind.
Okay. Bye.
Okay, bye.
Oh, she's so adorable.
Yeah, dude, being a dad is the coolest thing that ever happened to me, bro.
Fuck, I bet, bro. That's just fucking amazing.
Dude, I love being a dad. It's like so fun. Like, I just like, there's nothing else I'd rather be doing. Like, I mean, I work, obviously. I have to like pay bills and stuff. But yeah, like, I just love being with my daughter, bro. It's so fun. It's so cool. Like,
it hit me when you told me that there's no other love like that. And I mean, you've had a female, you, your mom, your grandma, family. And you said there's no other love compared to that. And I was like, damn.
Like, I love my mom to death. I would say that was a woman that, like, for any guy, that's your first love.
Yeah.
Like, if you have a good mom.
Yeah, oh yeah.
If you have a good mom, your mom's your first love. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But, like, even, it's uncomparable. Like, the love for my daughter. Because it's also, like, I want to take care of my mom, obviously. But, like, the kind of care I have to give my daughter is different.
Yeah. to be there for her.
Yeah.
Pick her up if she falls type shit.
Yeah, exactly, bro. Oh, and yeah, it's bro. Just like, even providing, bro, like from that sense, like it's different.
Yeah.
Like, you know, I'm not making money right now just cause, like, or even this, like, house, like, it's not just for me no more. Yeah, bro, like, it's just the craziest experience. I don't really talk about it much on this channel, you guys, but yeah, being a dad is just, like, the coolest shit ever. Like, it's hard, it's not easy. I don't recommend you do it hella young, but when you do it, I just, my best advice is enjoy it. You know what
fuck
I mean?
Yeah.
Because it's fun, bro.
And fulfilling as fuck, I bet, huh?
Mm-hmm. It's just kind of like, her, like, she's just coming back. When are you coming? Like, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
That's cool, bro. Or when, like, I've been working all day, and I get home, and I pick her, like, picking her up, and she'll be like, Daddy! She's just, like, running me, and she'll, like, hug me, like, where have you fucking been? And, like, you know? And that shit to me is just, like, so cool, bro. It's, like,
it hits you, huh?
It's a different cool, man. Like, I just think the coolest thing was somebody recognizing me on the street.
Yeah.
You know? And I'm like, that's cool. I love you guys, and I love it. But, like, the coolest shit for me is my daughter just, like, spending time with her and just, like, all that. Yeah, it's fucking fun, bro.
God, bro. That's beautiful, pa.
Yeah, man. I ain't trying to vent so much about my daughter and shit, but, like, you know, it's cool, man. Like, that shit's, like, yeah. It's something else, bro. That feeling, that experience, like.
Yeah, when you told me there was, like, nothing like it, I was like, damn. That must be true then, shit.
Yeah, and, like, for other young guys out there, like, I don't know. Like, maybe it's because I had a girl. So I feel like it kind of hit that space in my world for, like, girls.
Yeah.
But, like, I feel like I no longer, like, need any woman, like, besides my daughter.
Damn.
You know what I mean? Like, any woman that comes is, like, a cherry on top. If they're a good woman and, like...
Yeah.
They provide, like, not just provide, but, like, add in a way to, like, me and my daughter, you know?
Yeah.
But, like, I don't need one, though. Yeah. And I feel like as a young man, as, like, even humans in general, not just men, like,
that's
women
big.
And men, everybody feel like they need somebody.
Oh, yeah, that's big. That's why people stay in toxic relationship for years.
Sure.
Like, that is big, bro. You can't live without another person.
Yeah, people tell themselves that.
Yeah.
But, like, you know, I spent a lot of nights by myself and with my daughter, and I just realized, I was like, I don't need nobody.
That's right.
Like, literally, bro. Like, I'm so happy with, like, this. Like,
it's enough
for me. Everything on top of that is, like I said, it's like a cherry on top,
right?
But I'm not, like, hungry for that, you know what I mean? Like, you know,
I get what you mean by that. Like, this shit is, like, it fills that void that people
that we create,
that
you
we
know,
create. There isn't
society creates that shit.
Yeah.
Start making you believe, like, oh, girl, like, you have to be like this, like that, get married and have kids, and, like, boo, 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 boo. But
have
it's,
a house.
You know what I mean? Yeah, have a house. And all that
fucking 23, you gotta have a house. You're fucked.
It is not like that no more. In my opinion, we live in a very different time. But
we do.
But yeah, it's like, all I'm saying is, like, I feel hella good, bro. I feel like I'm in the healthiest situation of my life. I feel like even the relationships I'm building now are hella healthy.
Yeah.
Yeah, with, like, you, with, like, my parents, with, like, the home, like, everything, like, my daughter, like, I feel like they're all healthy, like, they're all so genuine and shit, like.
So that's about, yeah. Bob. Like, things start falling into place, you know?
See you later, so. I feel happy, man. I feel complete. And I know I haven't uploaded as much, you guys, so I do want to apologize to you guys. I just think I'm in a different time in my life, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm growing up. I'm fucking... My warnings are not wake the fuck up and just smash a fat joint to the face unless I don't have my daughter. But most of my mornings are waking up and brushing my daughter's teeth and making her breakfast and, like, life is different, bro. Like, you know,
yeah.
And I'm glad I'm where I'm at.
Yeah.
Because I feel way more grown and shit, like.
Yeah. That's right. You feel rooted, grounded, right?
Mm-hmm. People, like, 5-10 years above me, still, like, a lot of them I seem like kids, you know?
Finding,
like,
themselves.
Yeah.
I feel that's where I'm at, bro. Crazy. Like, I'm finding myself, bro. Like,
which is normal, like, to an extent, you know? But I'm not even trying to downplay nobody, but I just, like, people way older than me, I feel like I'm getting more life experience even through, like, all of this.
Dude, I'm telling you, on my job, I see all the time, fucking adults are just grown kids, bro.
Yeah.
They don't get what they want, or they don't, bro, they're just grown fucking kids at the end of the day, bro.
It's crazy. Yeah, but let's see how far we are into this thing right now, you guys.
Yeah, but this thing is bad.
We're 47 minutes in, so it's fair to say
this burns for over an hour. So if you wanna have yourself a good jolly old time, you got the homies over, you're gonna do a little party, whatever, I'm gonna hook you guys up. Make sure you guys check the link down below in the comment section, man. Your boy Mr. THC, hit the subscribe button. Shout out Purple Rose Supply, man. Shout out my boy Tricone. No, appreciate you coming through, my boy.
Bro, thanks for the fucking invite.
Shout out. I'm lit. And I'm out. Yes, sir.
Let's go.